Hello there, I'm your resident economist, Alex Holmes, and today we're going to be taking a look at the rise and rise of artificial intelligence. If 2023 was a breakout year for AI, what can we expect in 2024? The battle lines are still being drawn, but competition looks set to be fierce. We're going to take a look at some of the data and try and set the scene for the coming AI battle royale. Welcome to IC Your Trade Extra. I'm your host, Alex Holmes from Oxford Economics. IC Your Trade is brought to you by IC Markets, a leading high-performance trading provider. Trade up to IC Markets. Okay, we're going to take a look at a series of charts that help to show just how rapidly this AI train has left the station. If you're listening to audio only, don't worry, I'll talk you through the data, or you can take a moment now to switch on your video screen. So first off, let's look at the size of the price. This first chart shows that AI is expected to grow at a rate of about 17% a year. Under some optimistic scenarios, AI could contribute more than 10% to global GDP by the end of the decade. Why so much? Well, past revolutions, be they industrial, automotive, or the digital revolution, have indeed been revolutionary. The clue is in the name, but they've not reached every corner of the economy, nor did they happen particularly quickly. The first key difference with the AI revolution is how pervasive it could be. Theoretically, artificial intelligence could enhance any economic activity where human intelligence is an input, which is, well, virtually everything. The second is the velocity of change. AI is progressing so quickly that developments are almost impossible to keep up with, even for those deeply plugged in. This all fits with the trend throughout the last 250 years of innovation cycles becoming shorter and shorter and increasingly impactful. And talking about those who are plugged in, you know who understands all these numbers better than anyone else? All the billionaires and tech CEOs jostling for position in the AI arms race. Now let's look at who is out in front at the moment. One person with a claim to that title is the CEO of Microsoft, Satya Nadella. Around this time last year, Microsoft invested $10 billion into OpenAI and proceeded to spend 2023 integrating the technology into pretty much every single Microsoft product they could think of. Office, cyber, search, cloud, I could go on. And talk about a return on investment. At the start of last year, Microsoft had a market cap of $1.7 trillion. Now it's worth over $2.7 trillion. It would not be controversial to say that that $10 billion investment accounts for a big chunk of $1 trillion of extra market cap. And despite that little kerfuffle with Sam Altman and the board over at OpenAI, Microsoft looks set to capitalize on its investment even further in 2024. But of course, there is no standing still. Waiting in the wings is Google, which recently released the Gemini model. Elon Musk is gearing up for war, and Mark Zuckerberg is also scrambling to keep up with this megatrend. And that's not to mention all of the micro and mid-sized firms rapidly innovating. And of course, don't forget about the rest of the world. The Chinese technology behemoths, Baidu and Tencent, actually have the most AI patents of any private company in the world and are about 15,000 apiece. And really, we've only talked about one battlefield here. What about the people who design the AI chips? There are plenty of firms looking to catch up with Nvidia. And who will make these chips? Will it be all about the Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Corporation still? Or will China's SMIC catch up? While it's still anyone's race, there's an old saying that a rising tide lifts all boats. And of course, as this chart shows, the tide is rising on AI. It shows the forecast level of investment into AI over the next 2 years. As you can see, the US and China are clearly throwing money its way. And who gains from this frenetic pace of competition? The clashing tech giants, the hungry upstart firms, the nations pouring in billions upon billions of investment. Well, while shareholders will undoubtedly make a pretty penny, the winner ultimately, I think, is probably going to be the consumer, you and I. AI is going to change the world. It has the power to make us more productive and to give us more choice. It is going to change the way we live, work, and interact with each other. Hopefully, all for the better. One thing is for sure though, it's only just the beginning. Thanks for tuning in to IC Your Trade Extra. IC Your Trade is brought to you by IC Markets, a leading high-performance trading provider. Trade up to IC Markets. We'll be back shortly with our full episodes of IC Your Trade. Watch our socials for updates about the beginning of our next series of our award-winning VODCAST. See you soon.